Pyxel is a powerful game development library that allows you to create retro-style games with ease. One of the essential aspects of any game is the movements of sprites, which are the visual elements that make up the characters, objects, and background in a game. In this video, I will show you how to move a sprite using the keyboard in Pyxel. Let's start by reviewing what we have learned in the previous lessons. Main file in Pyxel game is likely to have one class and two methods. Constructor is going to be used for game state initialization. Method update is used to update the internal state of the game. And method draw is used to draw the current game visuals, things that the player should see at the current moment. This might be a perfect time to move our code related to the player into specialized class. This will help to separate the player logic from the other code. I have created the class player, which has some useful constants and several methods. In the constants, I specify the variables that I would need to pass to Pyxel function bleed in order to show the sprite on the screen. I also specify the amount of pixels I want my sprite to move for every frame. For the simplicity's sake, I will add just two methods for sprite movement, moving left and moving right. The initial coordinates for the sprite will be set in the constructor. I will also change the main application constructor accordingly. It will create an instance of the player class with the default coordinates. Pyxel provides built-in functions that allow you to check if a specific keyboard button is pressed. You can use these functions in your game loop to detect keyboard input and trigger actions accordingly. For example, this will check if the left arrow key is pressed. Pyxel provides predefined button codes for all the keyboard keys, making it very easy to handle keyboard input in your game. The next step is to map the keyboard keys to sprite movement. In our case, it is going to be extremely simple. We will just call the corresponding methods of the player class. Finally, I need to change my draw function. It will just use constants provided by the player class to identify position and the size of the sprite. Let's test our code. It works just as expected. In the next video, we will learn how to use Pyxel Resource Editor for creating tile maps. Just in case you didn't know, a tile map is a technique used to create levels or environments by dividing them into a grid of small, uniform-sized squares called tiles. These tiles can represent various elements such as terrain, objects, obstacles, or characters within the game world. By arranging and combining different tiles, developers can build complex and visually appealing game environment. That was all for today. It was Test Encoder. See you around!